Thank you very much. Special guest of honor, Ashwin Jetley Ranton, for his service.
Honorable Son Wu for his very generous remarks. And but I have two complaints. First of all, I've been given the task of speaking immediately after Professor Oshibadu. And to make matters worse, I would have thought that, in fact, my second complaint is that until recently he was the acting president. I should have used that opportunity to ban all these dangerous, hazardous substances with which he has fighting us today. Oh, I've been sitting next to the wrong Oshibadu all this time. Permit me to start by heartily congratulating the family of late Chief Stephen Oluwole Awokoya for their unrelenting and inspirational exertions to keep alive the memory of their illustrious father. However, I must really contradict myself on account of the monumentality of the task they have set themselves. In any other civilized part of the world, the exceptionalism of this noble family would long ago have been accorded national recognition. In such nations, exceptionalism is relatively acknowledged, nurtured, and preserved for future generations. Hence, we must sympathize with our hosts and plead with them not to surrender to despair. Rather, we must urge them to soldier on until the battle is won in a country that is under the reign of terror, exemplified by shock and fear as evidence of not only the collapse of education, but also the subversion of science by ignorance and poverty. Now, we are all IDPs, internally displaced persons, living in fear of kidnappers, armed robbers, con artists, looters, and money doublers. With all due apologies, we must be frank with ourselves and admit that the IDPs are not limited to those in refugee camps. By the same token, those who have failed us and consequently frustrated the fulfillment of the high but legitimate expectations and lofty ideals of Chief Stephen Awokoya and many others of his generation have by default consigned us and condemned future generations to the rapidly elevating list of internally displaced persons. To put matters bluntly, Chief Stephen Oluwole Awokoya was awesome. His contribution to education in general and science in particular suggests that he drew inspiration from Plato, the Greek philosopher who wrote on marble, and I quote, "By education, I mean that training in excellence from which youth upward, which makes a man and woman passionately desire to be a perfect citizen and teaches him or her to rule and to obey with justice. This is the only education which deserves the name. Our reference point deserves repetition. The emancipation of the entire western region of Nigeria by the indefatigable Chief Awokoya, under the visionary leadership of Chief Obafemi Awolowo. By that singular feat of launching the free primary education in 1955 without borrowing a single naira or dollar, it was a stellar demonstration of leadership anchored on commitment, determination, selflessness, and a grand vision, which was rewarded with reciprocal trust and sacrifice. We cannot but marvel at their statesmanship as well as exemplary management. In conclusion, I would like to add that perhaps it will not be out of place for me to disclose that every Friday night at the Lagos Motor Boat Club, the corner of the club is the arena or battlefield for a marathon debate between old boys of King's College Lagos and old boys of St. Gregory's College over the unresolved issue of which school is or was better within the ambit of their long-lasting rivalry in academics, sports, literary debates, and chasing girls. I must confess that as we speak, the old boys of St. Gregory's College are entitled to bragging rights based on their successful transformation of their school, which was in danger of collapsing on account of overcrowding, poor teachers and poorer teaching equipment, lack of funds in discipline, etc. It was the old boys of the college who came to the rescue and invested massively in their principal, Monsignor Babashayi Akwala. Today, the school is back to its old glory, looking pristine and majestic. You will even be mistaken for a university campus. The least you can do is to recommend Monsignor Babashayi Akwala of St. Grace College of Walende and Mr. J. Balamosi, who celebrated his 90th birthday last week. He was principal of Abuja College, for commendation by President Muhammadu Buhari. But I insist, nothing will disturb our weekly dwells at the book club, where the vigorous debate usually lasts until well after midnight, accompanied by a generous lubrication provided by wine, champagne, and exotic dishes, such as compensation for the lousy food we all endured at our respective boarding schools. Let me just read the last paragraph, which is directed to the Awokoya family. The departed Chief Awokoya, whose spirit we can invoke only with trepidation, provided both the roadmap and compass to greatness. The navigation has been handed over to his successors, who should grasp the netto by launching the Stephen Oluwole Awokoya University. Finally, I must confess that as a Lagosian, I can readily appreciate why the Awokoya children adore their late dad. In Lagos, we have our own language, Eno, which many of you may not know. It is a subtext of Yoruba. Beyond that, we have our own religion, Abalaye, which is neither Christianity nor Islam. Rather, it enjoins us that on the Day of Judgment, when the Almighty is seated on his throne, it is our fathers who will plead for forgiveness on our behalf, on one condition only: Lord, spare them, they have been good children. The evidence is overwhelming. The Awokoya offspring have indeed been very good children. They deserve not only our thanks, but also the abundant blessings of the Almighty. Thank you.
Thank you very much.